Welcome to Anole Alley. It's a beautiful early autumn day. The sky is blue and clear. Leo's back on top of the iguana's hutch, probably looking for something to eat. He's also looking great. The picture of perfect health. It's been quite a productive season for him so far. And it's not over yet. Leo is the dominant male. And of course, he has full rights to the top of the hutch over all the other Anoles. For the moment, he's content to lay here and soak up all those solar rays. And Sam has returned. I haven't seen her in a couple of weeks. She's no stranger here. We've followed her since the beginning of season two. We've watched her grow and mature into the backyard's dominant female. She looks a little thin. She's probably been away laying her eggs. Now, she's returned to the feeder to replenish herself. Here, near the bottom of the hutch, is one of the new kids. In the last episode, I introduced you all to Skipper and Yoshi. This is a new hatchling from the second wave of the baby boom. In late August through September, we see lots of them arriving. Just like all the others, this little guy must learn to avoid the dogs. Roxy hasn't seen the tiny Anole, and she probably won't. Soon, she's off to play in the yard. The Anoles can breathe a little easier. And now, Skipper and Yoshi have made it to the top of the hutch. Leo has disappeared. Vincent watches from afar. He's no threat. But there is a problem. You see, Skipper and Yoshi can't stand each other. Typical. Skipper's angry. He wants that feeder all to himself. He sends Yoshi a warning to stay away. Soon, the two meet in the middle. And the chase is on. And over. Well, that may not have been one of the most graceful things you'll ever see, but it may be one of the most amazing. Skipper has caught himself a honeybee, another stinging, venomous insect. Although not as powerful a sting as that of a yellow jacket, it's still painful. I've watched these Anoles catch these stinging insects with amazing precision. The Anoles know they must catch the bees head first to avoid being stung. While Skipper is preoccupied with his meal, Yoshi returns to the feeder. Will he take a B as well? Instead, he goes for something a little smaller. He seems to be a bit intimidated by the bees. Now, watch closely. Keep your eyes on the two honeybees. See that? What you are witnessing is intricate bee behavior and communication. One bee has given the other bee nectar and explicit instructions as to what to do with that nectar by doing what's called the waggle dance. Bees have some of the most sophisticated language skills in the animal kingdom. I don't think Yoshi's impressed, though. He continues to watch as the bees do their thing. Well, I think he's had enough of that. On the other hand, Skipper can't get enough of the honeybees. Anoles do have a sweet tooth. Don't worry, Caesar's not going to steal it. Again, notice how Skipper has the bee head first. He disables the bee's stinger by rubbing it back and forth against the wood. Anoles are tough little critters. And look who's back. Speaking of tough, I recognize this guy by the dark spot. This is the young male who took on those yellow jackets. All of these anoles are eating their fill, fattening up for the winter. Yoshi keeps an eye on the stranger from the feeder. While Leo has been watching all the action from the blind. Well, Leo, my friend, looks like you're going to have some pretty tough competition from all of these new kids. And from an old nemesis. Meet Ziggy. Named by one of the viewers, Ziggy is the young male who's been showing up here on a regular basis. He's now decided to move in full time. Now that Leo spends most of his time near the house. What is she doing? Is she chasing the anoles? Oh no! Leo! Sam! There's Leo. Well, at least he's safe. But what about the rest of them? Will they be able to escape the wrath of Roxy?